Hello, let's create a space station, but let's first delete this default cube, so... Not again. Please say it's gone. First, before we start doing the space station, let's do few selecting practices here in Blender, so I can be sure that you know what I'm talking about. So let's press Shift plus A and let's add here torus. And let's make this a little bit more detailed with these settings. Alright, this looks very good. And then I go in edit mode and I need to disable this ambient occlusion. And then I go face selection mode. And now if I select one of these polygons here and then I select other one, I can with Ctrl plus Shift plus Numpad plus repeat this selection pattern like that. It's doing very good job to select all of those like that. So now I have selected full loop of those and now if I press Ctrl plus, I can make those selections a little bit bigger. So this is one way how you can select patterns in Blender. But there is other ways also. So let's go here in edge selection mode and let's select with Alt plus Shift plus right mouse button one ring like this. And then let's go here in select menu and use checker deselect like that. And this will create a pattern also like that. And now we can change these values until we find a good pattern for this. Let's say I like this one very much, and then I can select one ring to the opposite direction, like that one, and then I again can select here, checker, deselect. And now if I go back to select menu and use edge rings, I will create a pattern like that. Now I need to convert this to faces, so I will make those other things disappear. So now I can again press Ctrl plus and I will have very good looking selection. Okay, let's try again with this. So if I select this ring again, Alt plus Shift plus right mouse button and then select menu and checker deselect and let's make those maybe a little bit closer of each other. Something like that and then I select this ring the opposite direction again. And now I go back to select menu and edge rings. I will create a selection like this one. Let's convert it back to faces and we disappear those other things. Cool, isn't it? And then one last thing is to select here this ring. Maybe it's not last. And then here random and then deselect. And now we can change the amount of those. So we will create a random selection of those. And then opposite direction and let's use again the edge rings thing. So we will have a random selection of those things like that. And then again this random and then select and then let's use only little amount of those and then select edge rings. So we will get something like that. We can get lots of different random selections like that. So it's always different. So yeah, now you know how you can select patterns in Blender. And these methods are very good. So now I think you know the settings needed to do the model. So let's delete this one. And we are going to model this in fact with the Array modifier. Because this is the current way how we do those kind of things. So let's add here cylinder and let's go to edit mode and let's rotate it in y-axis 90 degrees and let's delete both of these caps from this cylinder. And let's press Ctrl plus R to add loop cuts here and something like this looks very good. And then let's go here in modifiers and let's add here the Array. And then let's add here the simple deform and from the settings blend. And we wanna it's not blend, it's bend. We wanna go full round with this one, and now we can control the size of this thing, and I think 10 would be very good for the start. So let's keep adding details here. Let's go to face selection mode, and I will do selection that looks like this, and then I just extrude it a little bit inside like that, and I think also smooth shading would be very good for this. So let's activate that, and then let's go here in object data and let's activate smooth shading, so it will look a lot better. I will do a selection here and here, and let's see, I have four faces, and let's extrude this one here out like this, and then I wanna insert here to make some sort of panels here. So let's press I 2 times to create this kind of details here, and then let's extrude this out. And now we need to add here materials, otherwise we will end up having problems. So let's go here in materials and let's create new material, and let's call this hull. And let's add new material again, and let's call this panels. And now we will we keep this selected, and let's press Ctrl plus and let's select the panels and assign. And now if we select the hull material here and change the viewport color, we will see the difference of the materials. And then let's keep adding details to this. Let's press I 2 times again, and let's extrude this in. And now I need another material, and this is going to be, let's say, windows. Then assign and remember to save your project. I will call this to be a space station. Actually think I need to have let's go here in modifiers and let's disable this one so we can see a little bit better. So I also wanna have windows here, and then let's assign the windows material here. Actually I wanna change the color of those windows a little bit darker so we don't get mixed with these windows and the panels. I wanna have here a thing, some sort of thing. I don't know what is it supposed to be, but I wanna have this kind of break the shape with this kind of things. So let's delete here, and I also wanna see my modifiers again to see how this works. And then I think this is a little bit too small, so I move this a little bit down to have something like this. And then let's add here one loop cut, Ctrl plus R, and then face selection mode, and let's add here also windows, but this time maybe a little bit smaller. Extrude, and then the windows material here looking pretty good. Now I think we need more panels. As you can see, the modeling things like that are quite simple, but it's very fun and pleasing workflow. Are those panels a little bit overkill, or is it okay to have like that? Maybe I will leave those at least for a while. I will create also windows here, but not all of those are supposed to be windows. I will create an area here in the center just because I can, where I don't have windows. So let's press I 2 times and let's extrude in and assign the windows material. And now I can select this area here and extrude out, and then I again 2 times and extrude in and create the windows here also. So we will break the shape again a little bit. And now I think I will move to this area. So let's select the area and then deselect this center thing here, extrude in and delete these faces, and then I will make this to be a little bit bigger. So extrude again and then inset and extrude the panels out. I think that looks cool. If you wanna see a little bit better what's going on there, you can go in modifiers and activate this setting here, which will make all of your faces to be visible here in a correct way. And I will select with Alt plus Shift plus right click these rings here, because I wanna extrude them inside to create shape like that, and then I again need to delete some faces here, which I don't need. That looks very good, and then I will add also here some windows. Okay, then I will select these and I extrude them out a little bit. And I will create a bevel here, so let's select this in edge selection mode, Alt plus C plus right click, Control plus B, and let's add here the bevel like that, and then I will select again this and then I extrude it like that. It sometimes is good idea to disable this one to make it look more kind of less weird, and you will understand a little bit better what you are doing. Okay, and then I will select here few of these faces and I extrude them again, and I will select here the center ones and I will inset these and I extrude them in like that. Looking pretty good, and let's see how it looks like when we are activating these modifiers. Looks like that it's a little bit too, how can we say it, a little bit too deep. So let's reduce the amount a little bit and let's see again. Still too much. And now we need to scale this in x-axis a little bit to keep this not getting too thin. Okay, I don't know what I did, but I will move them a little bit down again to fix that problem. And I also would like to have here some holes for that, so that's why I add here loop cuts. And as you can see, now it creates that kind of distortions, and this is again because of this simple deform. But I think I'm okay with those. I will just select this one here and the other ones here underneath of those. And then let's press I 2 times to create an inset. And then we can here select individual origins and scale in x-axis. Let's press X and delete faces, and we have here very cool holes, and we can now create the surfaces here, so it looks real. So let's just keep selecting these and adding here faces. And by the way, I'm using the F2 add-on, so user preferences here, add-ons, and F2. And with that you can create very fast of those faces. Okay, I think it's now alright. Now I think it would be cool idea to have here some little bit smaller torus here. So that's why I go back to edit mode and then I disable the visibility of simple deform, and then I need some faces here. So I select this one here and Shift plus D duplicate them and extrude them in Z axis. Like that, and then I delete these top faces And now I can select all of these four of these edges, and Control plus B, I will add bevel here. And maybe I make it a little bit bigger, so let's select it and then S to scale, shift plus X, and let's move it in a place where we think it would be good. Maybe let's scale it again, S, shift plus X. Maybe it was a little bit too big. I will select here one ring like that. Yeah, that looks okay. Actually, and then select checker, deselect. And then we need to find a pattern that is working with this or shape. So let's select, for example, every second of those. And this works pretty good. Let's press I to inset a little bit. And let's extrude in. And then I will do also here. Thing like that. And then I think I can activate this back. And now I press I. And I'm targeting to have this kind of very cool looking. Cool looking shape here. By the way, now I think it would be a nice idea to have here an ambient occlusion, so we can see a little bit better how the shape looks like when we have some highlighting here. So now we can add even more meaningless details here. So let's, for example, here add some windows. Wait a minute, like this. Okay, it's easier to when we can see where the meridian point is. Then extrude in, and then assign the windows material. And by the way, we created a problem there. If you remember this, now we just need to manually select of those. And luckily we don't have too many of those, but if we created a selection like all of these faces, it would be fine to select those all, but now it was quite easy to fix. And if it of course don't look anything when in rendering mode, shift plus Z, because we don't have there any materials except those placeholders. I think I will create some random shape here. Extrude in, then inset again. Then assign windows there. You know, random shapes are cool. Maybe insert this. Insert again. And F6, maybe let's add a little bit depth for those. Then let's extrude in and assign the windows material there. Now I think it would be a good idea to extrude this a little bit out. And then let's select these two and Control plus B, bevel them a little bit. And it would be a good idea to have some sort of pipes here. So that's why I select here. Actually, I need to disable that for a while now. So I have this one here, and let's delete by the way this edge. Okay, so let's select this one and C plus S, cursor to select it. And let's add here cylinder, and let's make it really small, like this one. And we also don't need so many of those vertices here. Let's say maybe 10 is enough. And also the depth would be smaller. And rotate X 19 degrees. And because this face here is inside of the shape, we can delete the face. Okay, extrude this one. Rotate X and move here, extrude again, rotate X and move here. So let's select this one and then bevel, and now we can select here present and Control plus B. We will create a nice bevel for that, something like that, and then smooth shading. And now we can activate this back. And let's duplicate this one and let's disable this for a while. And C plus D, let's move the duplicated version here. Because I think it would be cool. Let's see how it looks. Looking really neat. And maybe I select here, let's say this one, and C plus D, T, Z, and rotate Y 90 degrees. And here, let's select median point, and let's, where is it? Here, let's scale it, and then extrude here. And let's select this edge here, and let's select here active element, scale X, 0. And now I can duplicate this one, and C plus D, and make the same job here. So let's select this one, scale X, 0. And let's activate here median point again. Let's select everything and control plus N. So as you have noticed, we can add infinite amount of details to this. Let's, for example, add here also something. Maybe this kind of some sort of holes, and then let's insert again F6. Change the depth to 0, and then let's extrude this. So we have some completely different kind of details there, which I think looks cool. Now it's a little bit bugging me this ring here, so I select it again with Alt key and then I move it a little bit back. Those details are... Oh, now I know what's the problem. I need to delete these. I accidentally had those also selected when I created those. That's very typical. Control plus delete faces. Control plus maybe more, delete faces. Okay, it's working, and now I need to create those back. Yeah, and now I need to select those and create the window material here. Okay, and then let's select this one and scale shift plus X to make it a little bit bigger, so it kind of looks like that someone can walk inside of this thing. And now I can create some sort of support geometry for this, so it looks like that it's connected with some way to this bigger part of this model. Maybe I scale this in like that. So let's, for example, I will select these faces here. Like that, C plus D, then I extrude them. Okay, I'm not going to extrude them. I'm going to insert them. And F6. And uncheck this one, and then let's add some depth to it, like this one. And then let's select this and extrude down. And I think this works good. Let's select it, Alt key, and scale in X-axis. And now we can also bevel that. And now it works better with this bit method. So let's undo and Control plus B again. Yeah. And I think we need more of these. So let's duplicate it and move here. Duplicate again. Move here and duplicate and move here. I think the next thing would be to add here the center part. So shift plus C, and in fact we might need to do that also with the same method. So let's add here, let's disable this simple deform so we can see what's going on. And then we need some edges, so this looks very good. So I select these edges and I duplicate them, C plus D, and I move them here and extrude in Z axis. like that. Control plus. I'm gonna locate it perfectly like that, and now I can activate this again. So now I have here this new geometry which I can use, and control plus N, I will rotate the normals. Actually, let's select this one only, control plus N, make normals inside, and that looks just fine. And then I can add here loop cut, and let's bevel it, control plus P, and let's extrude it. I think we have a little bit too much of things here with this object, so that's why I'm going to select. I will move this here, and then I move this up a little bit. Something like that would be fine. So we need to delete parts of this thing, whatever it is, and we can select here these edges like that, and then control plus and control minus. We select those areas and press X, delete faces, and now we can select this ring here, alt plus shift plus right mouse button and E to extrude, and let's move it in Y axis. So now we fixed that problem. And I also wanna create some sort of channel from this object to here to the interior part. Let's disable this again. And let's find some good place where we think the channel would go. The walking channel. So I think somewhere like here. Shift plus S, cursor to select it, and let's add here cylinder and rotate this in X axis 90 degrees, and then let's move this here. Delete face, and let's delete also this face. And smooth shading. By the way, if you want to, you can also bevel this. So control plus B. I think it's okay like that. And then we can activate this back. And now we have again this problem which is coming from that deform modifier. So we can fix that by selecting first this one here, and then we scale this in X axis until it looks like it's circular. So this looks good, and let's see this one. Scale this also in X axis until it looks being circular, and that I think is fine now. I will keep adding some additional details here. So let's select this ring here, extrude, and actually we can do it like that, I forget. Extrude and move here towards the center, and extrude and move in Z axis, and extrude again, and again, and you know. And then I will close this shape soon. I think I'm not going to apply these modifiers, but I'm going to apply. I need to apply this if I wanna kind of create closed shape with this. So I will activate those again, and let's add here some loop cuts. I can now select these and move them. And now I wanna have some pillars here, so I will again use the checker deselect here. Like this one, and C plus D, and then I use here mesh, from this menu, individual origins, and now I can scale these alone, and then I move them a little bit inside, and then I extrude them like that. So I have the pillars, and let's see how it looks like with the modifiers. I think it looks quite nice. So now I think I only need to add some additional details here to the bottom area of this. Maybe let's add here also some additional random details. I will add loop cuts here, and then I select this edge ring here, and then let's use the select checker deselect and delete edges, and I will create here that kind of random details also. I will bevel this thing a little bit. Then I go to face selection mode and then checker deselect again. For some reason sometimes checker deselect. I don't know why it's doing that, but because we are in space, the windows can be to any direction, you know. I think I would also wanna have here some windows. So I press W. And then I subdivide these, and then I press I to insert, and then scale in Z axis. And now we have an angle here, so if you wanna fix that angle, you should select these two and then press G to join them, and then you will create triangle there. Okay, seems like it's fixed now. I think I will start adding more angles here. So I will select this whole ring here, Alt plus Shift plus right click, and then I press W and subdivide, and then I add two levels here. And for those, I use select and random, and then I use here deselect. And let's make the amount to be something like that, maybe. Maybe change the seed. And then let's insert those things. So I don't know what those are. Maybe those are also going to be windows. So let's assign the windows material here. So now we have this kind of random patterns of windows here. You know. Or if that's for some reason don't make us happy, we can undo this like that, and then let's add here again that loop. Let's subdivide it again, and we can use here checker deselect to create this kind of pattern, and then again insert with I. Going on insert like this, and then extrude in, and then window material. So we have this kind of pattern. Or let's undo it, and let's try to use this method. Let's select this edge ring here, and then select checker deselect, and then this one here. And then let's select edge rings. So we have that kind of thing here, and then we can again insert this like that. To be honest, I don't know what's going on with those. Oh, it's the merging distance here. We have this distance here. Let's say 0.5. Okay, then I extrude this like that, and then I assign the windows. And that's all right. I think this needs also some sort of doors, so still there is that little gap. I don't know where is it. Why it's there. It's not there. Actually, it's also here. Well, I'm going to leave it and then I will fix it later. So, let's add the materials now. And I will select for the whole a principled shader here, and these are going to be very simple materials because I think this tutorial is going to end soon. So it's going to be something like that, and then maybe some metallic here, and no specular, and then some roughness. Let's see how it looks. Please Blender, don't crash again. So let's add some roughness here, like this, and let's see how it looks. I think quite nice, and then I will select these windows, and these are also going to be principled, and maybe base color to be black, and then specular to maybe full, and then a little bit roughness, and let's see how it looks. Looks, I think, quite nice, but there is also one thing that I wanna do with those windows. So let's go to face selection mode and then let's select all of these windows. And then let's create new material and let's make windows _ lights. And then here select random and we wanna use deselect this time. So now we will select the windows which have lights there. So something like that maybe. And then assign this. And this is going to be an emission shader. Let's see how it looks. Looks, I don't know. It's not so beautiful, but we can fix the material later. I think I need to change maybe the color of these windows. You have some tint there, and maybe I make this hull a little bit darker also, so those windows are a little bit easier to see there. For some reason, really low the scale models, you wanna make this look huge. You can select all the windows again, select these, and then select these. And we wanna deselect those small windows. So let's go to side view and let's deselect those. So we have only these big windows selected. And let's deselect these also. And these. Actually, it's harder to deselect those. Like that. Okay, those are deselected. And then let's deselect these. Do we still have small windows anywhere? These. So we will subdivide these. So let's press W. And actually, I will save this selection. Let's go here in the object data, click plus, and let's select here for the name big _ windows and assign, because I wanna save this model with the big windows. So let's duplicate this whole model, Shift+T and then M, and move that to other layer. So now we can play with this whatever we wanna do. These I by the way also deselect, and these. Alright, so W and then subdivide, and then I insert those again, two times insert, And now I have really big amount of windows here. Insert again. And then F6. Let's add depth. And let's see how it looks now. And we have no problem here because we have so many windows here, but the materials are wrong. So that's why we wanna select, again, we wanna save this selection also. So windows underscore x, one, sorry, I was speaking Finnish, and assign. And then let's press Ctrl plus to make the selection a little bit bigger. And then let's use the whole material here, like that. And then let's go back here to object data and let's select this windows thing and then materials and select this windows thing here. And then select random and now we can use any amount of lighted windows we want to. Something like that. And then assign this material here. So let's see how it looks. I think quite cool. Maybe we wanna have the space here, so let's go here in world and let's make the background black. Maybe almost black, something like that. So let's very fast fix the windows material. Let's go here in node editor, shift plus F3. And we have here this window lights on material, so let's add here principled. And let's mix those together like this. And then let's add here layer weight node and here the facing and let's see how it looks like now and with this we can make the effect stronger as you can see and I will also make this color here a little bit darker something greenish because that other one there also was greenish. And you can play with the intensity of this emission shader. I think I wanna have quite dim lights there because those are supposed to be a habitat lights. And maybe the color also would be something more sci-fi. I don't know. Let's add here noise texture to test what happens if we have here random colors. And then the scale. And we can add here color ramp. So we have green and blue colors on those windows. Looks at least interesting. Maybe I will insert some details also for these panels. So let's select the panel material. Deselect everything and then select this one, control minus, and we wanna subdivide these. So subdivide, and then let's add, for example, this amount of details here, and then I 2 times, and left click, and then F6, depth 0, and here. Little bit thickness. So by that way we can add here some different color for those. Let's see. Let's rename this material to panels underscore grid, then new material, and then panels, and then assign this here, and I will delete the diffuse, and let's add here principled again, and then maybe those are metallic and something like that. And then I can also add here some viewport color like that. So it will make it look much bigger by that way. As you can see, maybe the color for the panels would be something like greenish or ocean blue or something like that. And I think it's alright. I was doing some tests and I think about this whole material, the metallic looks in fact better than the old one. First I was thinking that it's some sort of carbon thing, but maybe it can be metallic. And no, just check some roundness value for that. Maybe also iron. 2.5. So the last thing is to apply this modifier here. So let's apply the array and let's apply the simple deform. And now we have the object finished. And let's select everything and press W and remove doubles. And it will remove all the edge area doubles there. And we in fact wanna have, okay, this is very good. If you have too big merge distance, it will cause some problems to you. And yeah, this is the space station. By the way, there is nothing here in the bottom area. I also added here an environment texture to the world settings. So I have that one environment texture which I rendered some years ago. And it's not perfect, as you can see there is some distortions, but you can download better environment textures from NASA website. So just go there and find something and download and use that. What I also did there is that I added with the flares wizard this lens flare. And the flares wizard is an add-on for Blender and you should use it. And then the other thing which I did was this motion blur, which I added for the render, and then I rotated this environment texture so very fast, so it created those light trails from these stars. So yeah, this I think is my final render out from Blender, and then I'm going Photoshop and I'm going to edit this. I hope you enjoyed watching this, and I hope I can see you in some other tutorial. So thanks for watching. Bye.